Welcome to this presentation on formative assessment with technology. To simply put, formative assessment refers to a wide variety of methods used to monitor and evaluate student progress before, during, and towards the end of an instructional unit, lesson, or class session. According to Greenstein, formative assessment has three essential principles. Number one, formative assessment is student-focused. Number two, formative assessment is instructionally informative. And number three, formative assessment is outcomes-based. Formative assessment is a cyclical process for continuous improvement, according to Greenstein. By providing information about student understanding relative to goals, objectives, and standards, formative assessment helps teachers to target their instruction for greater effectiveness and make responsive instructional adjustments. In this respect, teaching and assessing are intertwined. The overlap is beneficial to students in that they regularly receive feedback in the course of learning, and it's beneficial to teachers because they regularly receive information about their teaching. What is the difference between formative and summative assessment? Both are common methods of assessing student learning. Summative assessment is often used to evaluate student learning progress and achievement at the end of a project, unit, course, semester, program, or school year. Examples include final exam or performance-based assessment, such as portfolio and capstone projects. Formative assessment is often used during the learning process. Examples include exit slip, mid-unit quizzes, and conferences. In other words, formative assessments are for learning, while summative assessments are of learning. Why is formative assessment important? According to D. William, there are many reasons why we should implement formative assessments. Teachers can use formative assessment to check student understanding, monitor student progress, maximize student achievement, and minimize obstacles in students' learning path. How do we conduct formative assessment with technology? Here are a few examples to share with you. Some of the ideas are borrowed from Monica Burn's book on hashtag formative tech. Before a lesson or unit, we can use a KWL chart to scan students' prior knowledge and interest in a topic. Students share what they know and want to know about a topic. In a traditional classroom, they can write on a poster or a notepad. In a technology-friendly environment, they can use a tool called Padlet to share their responses so everyone can see each other's replies. There are many benefits to conducting assessment with a digital tool. All students can participate in the activities, and teachers do not have to rely on the opinions of a small number of students. Here's one Padlet example. Once a teacher has created a Padlet board, students can click to enter a note. Teachers can quickly scan student interest and adjust instruction. During a lesson, we can use think, pair, share activity. This activity gives students appropriate time to think about a topic individually and then discuss with a classmate and then share with the whole class. This is another quick way to scan student responses and understand of a topic. Use a digital tool such as Nearpod can encourage equal participation of all students. Here's a Nearpod lesson example on the topic of effective teamwork. Students can think about a topic first, then discuss with the classmate. They can then summarize their discussion to submit to Nearpod. Teachers can then share back selected or all comments with the whole class to find common ground, trends, or patterns on a discussion topic. Now, how do we do formative assessment after the lesson? Teachers can use an exit slip to ask students to reflect on two things learned from the lesson, or to ask questions that are confusing to them during the session. In a non-tech classroom, teachers would use paper and pencil for this activity. In a tech-friendly environment, teachers can use a learning management system or polling tools to ask students to reflect their learning. Two tools are ideal for this activity. Mentimeter or back-channel chat can collect student takeaways anonymously. So here are a few screenshots from Mentimeter. You can see there are a variety of ways to collect student exit slips. You can use word cloud, open-ended questions, or Emojo. Back-channel chats refers to the use of a chat tool for students to share their views, ask questions, and interact with each other during class presentation or activities. There is a tool also called back-channel chat for this purpose. This tool is a great way to engage peer interaction. It is also a great tool for exit slip, so students can reflect on their learning before the end of a session. In addition to conducting formative assessment at the beginning, middle, or the end of a class session, there are also many other ways to conduct formative assessment with technology. This pedagogical wheel is a comprehensive chart that is based on Bloom's taxonomy to identify instructional objectives and the tools to achieve or assess these instructional goals. The purpose of this chart is not for you to master the tools, but to think carefully about the purposes of instructional activities and then find the matching tool to maximize student learning. The pedagogical wheel can also provide a framework and tools for formative assessment. In the next few slides, we will visit a few specific examples. In Bloom's taxonomy, there are six layers of learning objectives for cognitive learning. Learning should take place at all levels, not just at the remembering and understanding levels, which seem to dominate most of the classroom assessment activities. To achieve each level, you can design activities to achieve the objectives with the suggested verbs in, but are not limited to, the bullet list. There are many digital tools to assess student performance at each level. Remember, all these tools can be used to achieve multiple objectives. It all depends on how teachers design the assessment activities to achieve a specific learning objective. In the next few slides, I will introduce you a few free tools for formative assessment. At the first level, remembering in Bloom's taxonomy, students should be able to recall facts and basic concepts. Kahoot is a highly interactive and engaging tool to help students remember essential content or facts. Quizlet comes with many built-in games to allow learners to master content through multiple ways, such as flashcards, matching games, or just simple multiple choices. The beauty of Quizlet is that it comes with many ready-made quizzes, so teachers don't need to recreate assessments. Socrative is another integrated formative assessment system that includes multiple choices, exit slips, true-false, short answers, and self-paced assessment. It also allows teachers to ask a spontaneous live question without entering the question into the system. Students' performance can be tabulated and exported to a spreadsheet. At an understanding level, students should be able to explain ideas or concepts. Plickers and Pear Deck are two excellent tools to check student understanding. Plickers is a low-tech tool that students do not need a mobile device. You can print out the student response cards as shown in the photo on the left side. Each student will use the card to respond to multiple choice questions. A teacher can then use a mobile device to scan the answers, and the result can be shown on a projector. Pear Deck is another assessment tool that comes with ready-made templates for conducting formative assessment. The teacher can embed the activity templates on Google Slides. Students can enter responses to a mobile device while following a lecture presentation. The results are displayed on the computer screen immediately, so everyone can see the responses. This is another great way to use this for access slip or checking student understanding. At an applying level, students need to be able to use information in new situations. Flipgrid and Telegami are ideal tools for this purpose. Flipgrid is a video social learning tool. Students can respond to a question by recording a video on their phones or computers. They can respond to each other's using videos. For example, students can use Flipgrid to practice a foreign language, to give a short speech, to engage in a global conversation with students from different parts of the world. For students who do not like to use their own videos, Telegami allows them to record short animated videos with customized avatars. Students can use this tool to record a public announcement, give a book report, solve math problems, to conduct a role play, and many other instructional activities. At the analyzing level, students should be able to draw connections among ideas. Students can use a concept map to compare and contrast the characters in a novel, or use an infographic tool to analyze a historical event, a concept, or statistical information. Both tools come with templates for customization. These are web-based tools, so they can be easily integrated into the instructional activities. At the evaluating level, students should be able to justify a stand or decision. They need to be able to evaluate their own learning. This can be done through reflection, discussion, reviewing, or peer evaluation. Use a learning management system such as Google Classroom, Schoology, Seesaw, Canvas with built-in discussion boards and peer evaluation tools will be ideal. Simpler tools such as Google Docs that has comments feature to allow peer commenting will be a good start too. At a creating level, students need to be able to produce new or original work. There are many tools for this purpose. Students can curate news, create podcasts, vodcasts, or digital stories. Flipboard is a good tool for creating online magazines by curating news. Anchor is a podcast tool for students to create podcasts on their phones. Powtoon allows students to create interactive presentation videos. Many of the previously mentioned tools can be used for creative work too. In the 21st century, creativity and productivity have become increasingly important learning skills. As you can see, the line between learning tools and assessment tools is gray. As mentioned earlier, formative assessment is student-focused, instructionally informative, and outcomes-based. Teachers need to embed formative assessment in learning activities to maximize student learning. This presentation is meant for a quick introduction to the purposes, principles, and tools for formative assessment. Please take time to explore them and continue to expand your digital toolbox for your own instructional purposes. Here are a few references used in this presentation. Thank you.